themselves.
They feel good about themselves. When we can make somebody feel good about themselves, can we get them to perform better, to perform more? I think so.
Definitely.
You know, just going there. Mark the Legend Schisler. Look who's in the building there. Unmute yourself, Mark. Welcome.
Hey, Claude.
How you been, buddy?
I've been good.
What's the word? How's your tell everybody what you do.
Well, I'm in technology sales for Oracle Consulting at the moment, and things are going pretty good.
And look who else is here. Jessica's in the building, Datrium. Corey, I'm living California to Giacomo. Corey, did you see that fog this morning?
Not up here.
Oh, really? Oh, man.
You're special people. You're close to the beach.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We can't. And there was a London fog this morning. It was amazing. Absolutely. And look who else is. Oh, look who else is in the. Hey, you got, and you other guys there, Jalen, Sandra, John Andrus, Dan Locke. We know who. Hey, Dan, I'm glad you could join us. He's a busy guy. They're all in the building here. I'll show you a little something real quick because you guys are the early birds. Let me see if I can, and if I could share my screen. Tell me if you can see that. This is something I was working on yesterday. This is something that'll be coming, the sales seduction. Mark even put on his glasses to read this. This is something I penciled out. I think it is so important to, when you get an idea, just throw it down on a piece of blank piece of paper, throw it down, save it, and come back to it, or try to get to a quiet place. And I really put that thing together. I was sitting in a Barnes & Noble. Claudia was buying a few books. I sat in one of those little tables. They have a Starbucks coffee shop. And I just started, you know, writing that out. And I'm going to work on that later today. And maybe there's a book there. Maybe there's a package. Maybe there's a whole new idea of how to persuade people. Justin Chamness, how the heck are you? Look at that.
I'm doing great, Uncle Claude. How are you, sir?
Good, good. How was your week? How many people did you speak to last week?
I lost count. You know, I just got so busy talking. I forgot to count, but it was a lot. And, you know, I made money and I increased my passive income by about $800 a month last week. Just alone. You know, talk about getting rental properties and stuff. And I hear people talk about getting rental properties. They're like, "Eh, well, this is going to put $250 a month in my..." Man, you guys got to get smarter.
you know, round of applause. $800 a month. That's one deal, one customer, one sale, whatever, one real estate deal. $800 a month. Let me see. Is that, let me see. Help me out. Who's my school teacher there, Bill? What is that? 96? Is that $9,600? Is that right?
Yes, it is.
I went to New York City school system, 800 plus another 16. It's 9,600. I'm right.
It's another Correct. Vacation is what it is, Uncle Claude.
It's almost another vacation.
Yeah.
It's almost $10,000, $800 a month. Does that pay a car payment maybe? Does that pay your Verizon bill? By the way, warning to the young guys in the audience. If you grow up and get married and you have children, your children stay on your Verizon bill forever. By the way, it's the one thing. It's just there. You can't take it away from them. Who else had a success? We got a lot of people coming on today. Who else had a success last week? Who else made money? Anybody make money? I had a great week last week. The last 2 weeks have been, I had 2 weeks that were really, I mean, I could hear crickets, and then I had 2 weeks where... Do you ever have those days where everything is just working? Everyone you talk to, all the offers you make, everything. Do you ever have one of those days? Okay. That's a good day. That's where you go and say, "Hey, honey, let's go out and celebrate," or something like that. That feels so good. Even $800. I'll take it, right?
Definitely.
you want to tell us how you did that? How you negotiated that?
Yeah, it wasn't just in one transaction, but I started out the month kind of slow, frankly, and took a hit or two. I don't know if anybody knows what that means, but I kind of took a financial hit, and I was thinking, man, this isn't no fun. I kind of took a step backwards financially. And so, I met with
We've
Uncle
all been
Claude.
there. We've all had more month than money. We've all had, well, I'm working really hard. I'm doing everything the guru told me to do and the Anthony Robbins, and I walked on the coals and everything, and I did it, and I'm still, I don't have two nickels to rub together. What am I doing wrong? It must, who is, what is it? That's self-doubt.
Absolutely.
We've all had that. How do we turn
I
it into?
started out that way this month, but then I met with Uncle Claude last week,
Gave him some vitamin C,
one
right?
on one. Yeah, some vitamin C. And that's the thing is, I've been doing this a long time, and once you've been doing it a while, you kind of revert back to, or you pick up bad habits. I don't know if anybody can relate, but I sure know what I'm talking about, because I have I've been doing this long enough that I've been great, and then I've been not so good again, and then I've been great again, and then not so good again. And then last week, Uncle Claude was talking about with me on a one-on-one about the perception of value with the client or with the prospect, right? So I really started hitting that hard, and an immediate turnaround for me. And so just from that point on, it was like stepping up to the plate and just hitting home runs one right after another. And I have to say that it was my fault. I got sloppy. You get sloppy. You get lazy, you get sloppy, you get cocky, arrogant, whatever it may be, and next thing you know, you're not closing sales like you were.
Yeah.
And so I just talked to a lot of people last week and created a perception of value inside the prospect, why they want to buy, and you got to focus in on that and then use their motivation to close them.
Yeah.
And it's that easy. So once I got back to home base and doing what I'm supposed to do, things just started smoothing out for me. So thank you, Uncle Claude, for helping me out there.
You're welcome. What does that perception of value mean? What does that mean?
Good question.
Give me a good answer.
That client or that prospect comes to you with something in mind, or you approach them, you have to create inside this conversation an emotional quality based on what they want, based on what they think, what their goals are, their desires are. Whether it's a motivated seller or a coaching student or whatever, there's something in there. And then when you can take what your offer is and cater it to that, and cause them to see it, like, oh, I see now, if I were just doing business with Justin, that this could be a real solution for me. This is the solution for me.
Is that emotional? I'm sorry to interrupt, but is that emotional selling or is that intellectual academic presentation?
There's almost no presentation, frankly. I mean,
Yes.
really.
What is your
That
competition?
that's the thing.
Yeah. What is all our competition? The other 99%, they get a prospect, they get somebody on the phone. Okay. What is their presentation? What do they sound like? They go right to this. They go right to the keynote, don't they? The script, the PowerPoint, or whatever, and they give all these features and benefits, and they just go right down. They don't know. It's like a doctor prescribing medication without talking to the patient first. It's like a lawyer representing somebody in court without asking them, "Hey, what did you do wrong, or why are these people suing you?" And I think we jump in head first into our memorized little presentation, our little scripted presentation, instead of having a conver the conversation. How do we, would you agree, disagree, Justin?
I totally agree. Up what I'd been doing, because I got sloppy, remember, was I'd been thinking, well, if I could just share with them all of the wonderful things that I'll be doing for them, that'll be enough to convince them. It's
Yeah.
not. It's not really, because that they don't give a hoot really about what you do, about what you do. They give a hoot about what you can do for them and what they want.
How do you bring that? How do you bring that out from somebody? Did anyone wake up this morning and say, "Hey, I'm going to call up Justin Chamness and give him a shitload of money and all my MasterCards and all my airline points"? And he's just a great. We wish, right?
I wish. Yeah, that'd be really cool.
So, what would it sound like? Ring, ring. Oh, go ahead. You can. This is a good role play I want to do. We talked about this with a few clients last week. Those of you who schedule with me privately, my mentees. And basically, one of the marketing techniques that I use is we give something to people. We give, you know, if you just go on the internet and you do your social media marketing, you text, you email, and you say, love me, trust me, call me, here I am, you know. You're not going to get a high response rate because we're in a world where people are scared to be spammed or be put in a sales cubicle, a sales position, right? Nobody woke up and said, gee, I hope I talk to a whole bunch of salespeople today who want to sell me life insurance, right? But they do love information, quality information. And that's, if any of you have read my book, Attraction Marketing, my whole marketing is free. I even get paid. I get clicks from YouTube. I get a check all the time from YouTube, Google for the content I put out there. And I always give information. I give away, one person once told me I give away better information than what they're paying for. Okay, why do I do that? Because it gets people's attention. And from there, I give away something for free. I'll give away a mind map, a book, my personal scribble notes on things. I'm always giving, every time I go on YouTube, I always give away something for free. And if you get good with YouTube, you can actually embed your link, your phone number, and you say, hey, text me. Okay, I do a lot of that rather than email. I do email too, but I love one. And I also put in a link for my scheduling system. So people either schedule with me to get something for free. They only get something for free if they schedule 15 minutes with me. So they get a product and they get a free consultation. But a lot of people, I'll say, just text me. Okay, I'm really giving you guys the keys here. I say, text me for this free thing. And I get something for, and then let's say Justin sent me something for free. Does Justin have the right, now that he gave, to call me up now and say, how did you like it? Any suggestions? Can he engage me in a conversation if he gave me a gift?
Yes, it's reciprocity.
Reciprocity. Mr. Cialdini talks so much about reciprocity, but we really don't use it. Justin, you mind if I put you, call me up and say, Claude, how did you like the mind map on how to raise chihuahuas? Anything, you know? You're
I'm sorry, you cut out there, Uncle Claude, for me.
I said, could you, am I, okay. Let's pretend you sent me a gift. I saw your video. You sent me all that. You have so much creative stuff. What's something you send out to your students?
I've got little books that I wrote. You know, and ChatGPT helped me. So I don't know if anyone out there is using that too, but if you've got ideas and you don't know how to put them into an ebook form, ChatGPT helps. So I've used ChatGPT to create about a half a dozen little ebooks. And I give those away for free as a hook. Is that an appropriate word?
I love the hook, the sales seduction. Go ahead. Do you have a right to call me up without any reservation? If you texted something to me, okay. If you sent that to me, let's say I heard you speak. I sent you a text. Gee, Justin, send me that free booklet. And you send it to me, let's say Friday or Saturday. Do you have a right to call me Monday morning?
Sure.
Hello. Hello. This is Joe.
Hello. Blow. Hey, Joe Blow. This is Justin Chamness.
I was just reading your book, man.
Oh, you are? Great.
I can't believe you're calling me. Oh, my gosh.
What's the big takeaway that you have from it? Anything that jumps out at you?
I'll be honest. I just started reading it and everything like that. But man, I can't believe you're calling. I just was watching your videos on YouTube and TikTok and all these places. Thank you so much for it. I really want to learn more about real estate and sales and negotiation and marketing and things like that.
That's great, Joe. That's a super, super thing to want to learn. But let me ask you a question. If you don't mind, I might ask you a couple questions and you can ask me some too. And if it's not a good fit, what we talk about today, that's okay. You can tell me no. But what are your goals? Why are you interested in real estate? Why are you interested in sales skills and learning the things that you just said? What is the real thing that, what is your biggest goal, Joe?
I'm in arm I do armpit repair on white t-shirts for athletes. It's not a glamorous job. And thank you, Daydream. I've always wanted to get into real estate. My hero Corey DiGiacomo, he's in real estate in California, and he's just crushing it. And I want to do what he's doing and get out of the dirty underarm white t-shirt business.
I see. So
That is pretty gross. Where did that come from?
it's
It's a niche.
It is. My
it
even
sounds
Claudia
pretty
said it's gross
dreadful.
down in the peanut gallery there.
Well, it sounds pretty dreadful, Claude. Why not just work there and get promoted up the ladder and become the boss there? I mean,
I've been there 15 years. I'm gonna go as high as you can go in the armpit t-shirt business. Can I ask you, how do you find those deals that you how do you find those great real estate deals that you always talk about?
That's a good question, Claude. I don't know if you're ready for that just yet. Because
I'm not driving. I'm okay.
well, okay, Claude. You got me stumped here now because I don't want to get into a pitch. You're asking me to pitch, Claude, and I don't want to pitch.
You
So.
want to? No, that's true. Prospects have a system, okay? You guys, I'm always teaching a gut system, great untraditional techniques of sales and success. And the prospects have a system too. What's their system? To if they get the opportunity to cross-examine us and ask us a million questions, are they going to do that? Do they love to pick our brain for free without making a commitment? Of course, right? They love free information if it's something they're interested in. What we have to do is turn it around, just like the psychiatrist and the patients on the couch. Why? Doctor, why do I dream of Randy George on a motorcycle all day long? Something like that. And you'll say, I don't know why you brought it up. It's interesting. You turn it around. How do you turn a question into a question?
Right. That's a great question. Why do you ask?
Because I really want to learn this business. I really want to leave my job. I really want to. I'm a little bit in debt here. I've really run up my Chuck E. Cheese pizza parlor, MasterCard. I want to pay off my mortgage. I have five kids, and they all want to go to dental college. I really need to make some more money.
Well, Claude, imagine that I were able to show you personally, one-on-one, exactly how I get these deals. That's not something you'd be interested in, is it?
You don't have a program or do some kind of coaching or something, do you?
Well, it's funny that you ask because I don't make this offer to everyone, but you and I have been talking and when you shared with me your goal and you shared with me about your family, my heart really goes out to you and I understand where you're coming from because I've been there too. And you sound like a good man. You sound like somebody that really cares about your family and you want to do good. So imagine I were able to really create a scenario where you and I can work together one-on-one and I can show you step by step what to do to achieve those goals. Not like years up the road, but in the short term, Claude. Is that something worth talking about, or maybe not?
Yes, it is. Time out. Use now those things I gave you. I want to pay the bills. I got kids in college. My wife's never seen in Mexico. Anything. Feed me back. Keep me in that emotional state and say, imagine for a moment there was a way, maybe through me, maybe through somebody else or something else, a solution for you where you could do ABC and just go through those three to five, six needs and greeds.
Okay.
Just and then get that yes out of me, you know?
I should have been writing them down, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, just imagine, Claude, that you and I working together, I were to show you how you can get out of that job working for the stained t-shirt company. and to have a home that you've paid for in cash, like I have.
Oh,
and
my God.
And the freedom that you experience with that.
That's a dream.
Coming home. Yeah, it really is. And your wife looking at you at the end of the day like you're a hero, and your children celebrating the fact that you're home, and that now you can celebrate all day long, every day, this gift of life together. Yeah. That's not what you're looking for, is it, Claude?
That's exactly what I'm looking for.
Okay, great. Well, I've made a decision. I like you, Claude, and I think we should work together. I want to work together with you. I'll be honest with you, this program costs money.
How much?
But it's $25,000.
Oh, wow.
For 3 years.
Wow, that's a lot of money.
It is a lot of money. And do you know why it's a lot of money, Claude?
Probably because you're really good at what you do.
I am very good at what I do. And this is one-on-one help. Okay, so I don't make this offer to everyone, but when I extend this offer, I extend it one time, and I'm making this offer to you. Now,
yes, here it is. Do you take Chuck E. Cheese Pizza Palace MasterCard?
I if it'll run through my merchant account, I take it, yeah.
There you go. Boom. Give him a round of applause. We don't rehearse this. You guys know. I just throw you on the hot seat, especially for the brave. Jessica, we see you there. You're in a hospital bed. Are you okay? Give me a thumbs up. Oh, rude.
I ended up in the ER and had to have emergency surgery. I had a twisted colon and blockage.
Ooh.
So I'm in for about a week. I'm rough, but I'm getting better.
Get healthy.
Tell, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I say thank you for being so brave to show us you're in the hospital.
I know. I'm all just about being real. So here I am, my best and my worst. You get everything.
No, well, we want you to get healthy real fast, real soon. Okay. Everybody give her a thumbs up. Okay, there we go.
I'm learning how to talk to the doctors the best way through Uncle Claude, right? To get what I need. The best food, the best service. No, it's gone. Everything's gone as best as can be expected. And I'm really lucky. And it's going to be a new, better, because I've been having trouble for a while. So it's going to be all new and better. So I'm happy it happened, even though it was tough. So
okay. So your son, Alex, right?
Yeah.
Alex is running the business. Alex, 6 months old. Alex is running the business now, right?
He's holding the fort. Yeah, he's so cute that everyone just, you know, falls in love with him. We're making more money, so
there you go.
I'm just going to retire early and put him in the CEO position.
Okay. Well, you get well fast. Okay.
Thank you.
Very good. Anybody have any questions about that role play that Justin and I just did? There was a lot, And by the way, the moves that Justin was doing are applicable. I don't care if you sell life insurance, used cars, dirty t-shirts, real estate, whatever you do. Is there a right way to speak to people? Rather than getting that high rejection rate and sounding like everybody else out there. How many of us get those phone calls and do we know in like a second that it's a sales call? Don't we know when we get those phone calls? Nod your heads, people. Something. Okay, good. Yes. Okay, we know that. What do we usually do? What goes on in our head? Is it positive? No way.
This is great, Uncle Claude. Thank you for this.
What do we do? What do? We hang up. We say, take me off your list. Leave me alone. Very few people react friendly to an uninvited guest. True? So we better not sound like that. So you have to always, so my, the my theory of marketing is always have somebody who contacted you first because you gave them a gift of some sort and you're following up. Say, hey, how did you like it? Can you give me your opinion? You have any suggestions? How long have you, gee, I was just curious if you got the material, the book, the mind map, the free link to schedule with me. Did you get that information? Oh, good. Why are you interested in apartment building real estate, commercial real estate? Why? Tell me a little bit about yourself. Do people like that when you show an interest in them or you ask them their opinion? They love that, don't they? That's how you, that's charismatic selling. That's I was talking for the early birds who came on. I'll share it with you guys real quick. This is future stuff that I'm doing. If you can see it, this was a little mind map I made the other day. I had a little free time. I was in Barnes & Noble by the Starbucks, and I made a little mind map here. I'm going to work on this. The sales seduction. How do we get people to know, like, and trust us, fall in love with us? Is it hypnotic? Is it charismatic? What is practical? What is permissible? What are the techniques, the methods, the words, the tone, the passion, the volume, the speed, the enunciation, the timing, the pregnant pause? Who knows what the pregnant pause is? Somebody asked me, let's do it again. Corey, Giacomo, you asked me, Claude, can you work? Claude, can you work with me? Can you finance me? Can you send me a contract? Say something maybe on the positive light.
Claude, I appreciate you getting on the point today. Can we come to an agreement maybe with a contract today?
Wow. You put me under a lot of pressure, Corey. I mean, I appreciate you asking. Thank you, man. Monday's my busiest. This is a crazy day. I have 8 appointments. I have a closing. I got to drive my wife. She's getting a pedicure. I got to walk the Chihuahua. It's one. Oh, man. Let me ask you something. If I could move a few things around and get you that contract, you wouldn't be able to fund it today or put something down right now. If I make that time for you, you couldn't do me that small favor, could you?
Yeah, I could. I can move some things around and possibly, yeah, I can make that work.
Possibly or actually?
Actually.
What?
Actually.
Oh, thank you. So if I understand you correctly, you're going to give me some kind of funds right now. I'm going to send you a contract. You're going to get it back to me before 4:30, and we're going to hit the ground running tomorrow on that deal we talked about.
Sounds like a plan.
I love doing business with you, man. You're comfortable with this decision?
Yeah.
You okay.
Covered all the bases.
You're not going to call me up tomorrow holding your little box of boohoo tissues or anything like that, right?
I'll get that out of the way tonight. So tomorrow we're good to go.
You know what? I love doing business with guys like you. You're a man of your word. You know,
I appreciate it.
Why do I feel that way about you?
It's aura. It's my aura.
Okay. That's called a super stroke. His back is wet now from me doing all that. Good role play. Good role. What did I do in the beginning? Okay. What did I do in the beginning? Did I say, yeah, sure, we can do business, whatever you want. You know, it's great. What did I do? Did anyone notice something?
Urgency. You put a date and you put a time on it.
Yeah. Did you see a little struggle? Did I do a pregnant pause? Maybe I didn't do it very well that time.
Scarcity.
You're busy.
Scarcity. What happens? What happens when someone asks you for something and you give it right away? Do they start to take you for granted?
Yeah, there's no struggle.
Do whatever you want. Don't worry. You want it today, next week, whatever. Don't worry about it. But when you struggle, how did that change everything?
That you're important and you have a busy schedule and you're working him in. So
when you say
internet.
You create value. Why is there a value created? Ty, I'll go to you next. Why did it create a value? When I struggle like that, and I tell you how busy I am, and the scarcity and the social proof, and I ask a little bit of reciprocity, all these Cialdini things that we always talk about, you know, why was that struggle so important, Annette?
Because if it's really easy for you to give it to them, it has no value.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, okay, I'll give you $10,000 for it. And they're going, damn, I should have asked for $12,000.
Yeah. Yeah. First dimension price always
loses.
Why?
Because the other guy second guesses it, realizes he should have asked for more.
Yeah. Sometimes, you know.
At least it creates uncertainty that maybe he could have gotten more.
Yeah. What are the three best words in sales when someone asks you a question that may be in a positive context? What are the three best? What's the best response? Ask me something, Annette. Claude, could you do this? Could you do that?
I don't know.
I don't know.
Randy said it. I don't know. Somebody asked me. A question. Gee, can you have it delivered by Tuesday? Something like that. Go ahead.
So, Claude, can you have it delivered by Tuesday?
Wow. Oh, my God. I mean, today's only Monday. I don't know, Annette. Oh, my God. Oh, why Tuesday? Why do you need this so fast, if you don't mind me asking?
We're ready to get started.
But we've never done business before. Is this a one-shot deal, or is this the beginning of a, as they said in Casablanca, Humphrey Bogart to Claude Rains. I even remember the scene. Is this the beginning of a beautiful friendship?
I would hope so.
Well, I'm going to have to stick my neck out to get a delivery to you by Tuesday. But what happens next time you need to reorder? Are we going to get your business?
It gets delivered on time, as agreed. You certainly will.
What? So, I'm sorry, what?
I said, if it gets delivered on time as agreed, you certainly will.
I'm gonna ask my boss for a favor. I'm gonna get it to you. If I have to load it on my bicycle, I'm gonna get you that delivery tomorrow, and then we'll talk every 2 weeks to re-up the order. Is that fair?
Sounds good.
Thank you. Appreciate your business, and I'll follow up. Boom. What happens when you struggle and you say, I don't know, and you're creating, I knew from the very beginning I could get it to her on Tuesday, okay? But what happens when you, did I get all her business now instead of her just dealing with me one time because her regular supplier couldn't deliver?
She's chasing you now. She's chasing you. Yeah.
Do we react? Do we get so emotionally involved that when somebody says, hey, Ty, and you know you can deliver it on Tuesday. Ty, can you get me that contract? And can we get this thing into escrow by Tuesday or Wednesday? Can we do that, Ty? And you know you can, but you don't want to. Go ahead, role play.
Right. So you draw it out a little bit. Oh, man, Tuesday. Gosh, my calendar's booked. I'm going to have to move everything around.
I really appreciate it, man. We got a club. My daughter's having her wedding in June. I want to do it in the backyard. I love the backyard on that property. And here we are. It's almost May. And how long? I know it's going to take 45 days to close on this thing. So if we could,
man,
I consider it a personal favor if you could help me out.
Oh, man. Yeah, I have to move. Let me see. I don't know. I could. Okay, I think I can if I. Yeah, it's gonna be tough, but for you, Claude, you know, since you're, I see the value in our relationship.
Well, he's struggling.
Sure.
He's really struggling. Now, get something back. This is a real estate deal. You're entitled to this wonderful word. It's the R word. Somebody help me. What's the R word?
Reciprocity.
Reciprocity. Can you ask for something back now? Like,
money
or a contract or something like that, right?
So I'm going to get this to you, and then what am I going to get back from you, right?
Yeah, but say it's sweet now. Now, remember, you're nurturing now. Okay. Oh, you know, give me a cookie. See, you know, I think it's so wonderful you're doing this for your daughter. Are you going through all this? Just
so
can have the wedding and the whole family will be there. And that backyard is just so beautiful. Go, give me a little, Give me more.
So you're going to have a beautiful wedding, and I see why this is important to you. And gosh, I get this for you. Yeah, by Tuesday for sure.
Okay. Now ask back for something. Now you want money.
Okay. Then you're going to come through with your Chuck E. Cheese credit card by 4 o'clock today. Is that right?
I could do it right now, but you want me to wait till 4 o'clock? When do you get Ty?
No, sounds good. But Ty, send that right over. I'll email you the invoice. I'll email it to you.
There you go. Ty, you're 16 years old. You just took out Betty Lou. She laughed at all your dumb jokes. And she closes her eyes and tilts her head. What do? I'll come back at 4:30 on Friday.
Smoochie, yeah.
Yes, smoochie. Go for it. Sometimes you just have to go for it. Nitzan Mosery, the new kid on the block. I want to see you there. How are you, sir?
What's happening?
It's happening. Tell everybody what you do, where you live and everything.
Sure. Welcome, everybody. Thanks for having me. I'm located in South Florida in Boca Raton, and I am in multifamily and student housing acquisitions. We buy Class A properties all around the country, and I also teach people how to do what I do to create passive income and generational wealth for their families.
Generational wealth. I love that's a sexy word. What does it mean?
It means that we're creating a company that will continue to acquire real estate even long after we're gone, so that our children can have that ease of life, so they don't have to stress and worry about it, so that they can have a foot up above everyone else when they get started in life.
And you specialize in student housing, I believe?
Correct. Student housing and multifamily.
Tell everybody what that means, student housing. What is that? What kind of invest? Where do you do that? By college campuses?
So we go into states that have what's called in-state scholarships. So, for example, in Florida, we have what's called Bright Futures. So any high school kid that excels in high school and then decides to go to a state-funded university, they get scholarships. So we look at states that have scholarships, and we go and we'll buy the nicest, newest property close to one of the tier one universities that is a purposely built property, meaning that it was built specifically for students and for student housing. And then we'll go and then we'll rent out per bed to the students. Their parents are on lease, the guarantor is on the lease. So if the kids don't pay the rent, guess what? Mom and dad are on the hook. And then we go out and we give them a great place to live, and our investors are happy.
Wow. You know, one of the biggest mistakes I made in real estate, both my kids went to the University of Wyoming in Laramie, Wyoming. Both of them went to the school. They're 4 years apart, 4 or 4.5 years apart in age. So one followed the other. So over the course of 6-7 years, I had my kids living in Wyoming, and do you think I should have bought some student housing?
Exactly.
Do you think my kids could have been if I bought a place like a sixplex and one of my kids was living in there who could collect the rent and manage the place and watch my investment? And then do you think I would have had some appreciation and pay down and depreciation on and save? Do you think I would have made some money on that property over, you know, 10 years later?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. We just bought a property in Athens, Georgia, by the University of Georgia, which is about an hour outside of Atlanta. And we closed on it December 28th of 2023. It's a one-year-old property, so there's really nothing wrong with it. We are now leasing for next year at $430 increase in average per bed, which next year when the students come in and they start locking in those leases, meaning pay on the leases, we would have increased the value of our property by over $9 million in one year.
Wow. Excuse me, if you don't mind, I live in Athens. Which one did you get?
It's on Tracy Street. It's called the Mills District.
Okay. It's not like the Reserve or Standard or whatever. It's on Mill Street.
It's on Tracy Street.
Tracy Street. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll check it out. Yeah, I work in Athens. I live right outside of it. Just when you said Athens, it piqued my curiosity, so to speak.
Yeah, great. That's my second property in Athens. Athens is a great market.
Randy, you wouldn't want to learn more about how to develop, find, finance, and structure deals like Nitzan was talking about, would you? You wouldn't want to do that, right?
Oh, no, no. I have no idea. No interest in making money, you know.
Hey, Nitzan, how would Randy get more information to learn more about this really great niche in his backyard?
Text me. I just put my number in the chat.
You wouldn't.
561-212-7247. Or you can go to my website, multifamilyinc.com/application.
But Randy's a little scared about talking to sales. I'm being facetious here. Randy's a great salesman. if Randy is reluctant, he just met you and he's a little worried about getting trapped in that sales thing. Could you offer him something tangible for free? Just to
capture.
Okay. What would that be? To learn more about
my five-step roadmap to getting into multifamily and student housing.
And what is that? What format is that in a PDF?
It's a PDF. It's a PDF. Oh. It's an ebook that I have. And it talks about the five steps that everyone needs to go through or to accomplish to be able to acquire multifamily or student housing.
Oh, and that's a mind map with all that information on, and he could read it and get a better feel on it, right? And all he has to do is what? Text you?
Yep. Just text me.
Just text you. Okay, let's hear you guys. I'm showing you the marketing to develop warm calls. This easy, it okay, just like this. Now, let's say you send it to Randy today. Do you have the right? Would you be comfortable to call him later today or tomorrow morning?
Absolutely.
What would you say to Mr. Randy George?
I'd say, well, hey, Randy, it's Nitzan Moser. How are you, man?
Good, good.
How was that five-step roadmap that I sent you? It's pretty amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm really interested. What does it cost?
Boom. Okay. What just happened? Were you comfortable making that call? Did you feel like you were intruding or cold calling or bothering somebody? Did you? No.
No.
How comfortable did you feel returning that? Do you have the right to return that call to Randy George?
Absolutely.
Right. And do you think that he got it? Do you think Randy has an obligation to you? Is there a little, because he knows who you are, you sent it to him, whether he read it or did not read it, does he still have an obligation to say thank you to you or acknowledge you?
Sure.
Are we opening up the door to a conversation?
Absolutely.
How great, how many people here, everybody's on two martinis and a little sodium pentothal. Okay. I did this through Zoom here. It's a special program they have. Okay. I use AI and the matrix and things like that. How many people here would love to just have those easy? Could you make 3, 4, God forbid, 5 phone calls to people you gave something for free? You rewarded them an incentive. Could you do that?
Absolutely.
How much easier would that be? To call back people you gave that gift to.
Yeah.
Okay. You can do all the other kind of marketing. There's two. I see marketing as kind of, Justin, I got to have you chime in on this. I see marketing as kind of black and white. I know there's the click funnel, the mailer, the texting, the VA, the buy the list, and send a lot of people who might or might not be interested in what you have to offer, or attract a few people with a gift and have those comfortable warm calls every day, rather than dealing with 10,000 people and filter them down to a few. Give me your, and I'm not saying I'm right or wrong. I just want your take on that.
My thought is that people don't do it long enough, and that's been my experience with my students that struggle. Okay. The students that struggle, they try marketing, and that's not what you do. You commit to marketing. Like, I'll give you an example. I've got a phone call that I got to return as soon as I get off here. It's a homeowner. I know this phone number. I know this homeowner because it's in my phone now. But this homeowner I've been talking to off and on about their property. I guess I started in December last year, and wow. Now they're calling me. So I guarantee you what will happen when I get off this call and I call them back is I'm going to employ some of these strategies that we're talking about here, because the reciprocity that how that sets up for me here is that I've made myself available to them. I've taken my time to listen to their story, and now they're calling me back because they want something, they need something. I have no doubt in my mind I will close this individual today.
Do you have good night? This is where your CRM, your notebook, your index cards, your spreadsheet, I don't care how, but can you remember, truth be told here, we're still on martinis and sodium pentothal. Can you remember somebody from 14, 15 months ago and the conversation you had? This is why you got to take good notes. True?
I do have a folder on this individual in my Google Drive.
See? Beautiful.
Yeah. And I already sent this person an offer and I didn't close them back in, I don't know, a few months ago. But yet I've dripped on them a little. So, you know, like I've always just, I've stayed in touch of sorts, you know, and today they need something, want something. So they're like a fly in my web, you know.
And here's what you have to do. And I've had clients come back to me 10 years later. Okay. And I still had the notes and everything. Here's the move. You want to know the move, the perfect move for this person?
Yes. Please do.
You know, you call, hi, Justin. You know, I'm so glad. Oh, how are you? How's the family? You know, how's the,
right.
How's the Q-tip recycling job doing, going and everything.
Right.
I got all my notes here. Let me ask you something. I know you have some questions about a deal or something, or that property, that piece of land you were talking about in Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
And everything.
Yes.
You and yeah. I, my notes here say you and I spoke about last December 2023 and yes. Everything. I made you an offer. What's going to happen today?
Yeah. Right. Well, you know, I've been thinking about it and I've tried some other things and they haven't worked out. And so I was just wondering if your offer is still available.
I don't know. It's a year later. Let's pretend for a moment. You can use the word imagine too, but I like just to change it up. Let's pretend for a moment. Let me pull that offer out. Let's pretend for a moment that offer, I made that again today. I resent it to you. I updated the contract and the date and everything else. What would you say to me next if I was to honor that offer from 15 months ago?
Yes, let's move forward.
What?
Yes, let's move forward. I'm ready to move forward.
Okay. Now, you know in your head you can't do that deal anymore for that price or those terms.
Right.
Or you offered. Okay. But,
right.
But this is a big capital B-U-T. Do you still make that move that I just did? What do you guys think? Why?
Yes.
Annette, I see your head just up and down. Thank you.
So here's the thing. I want to get her down about $150 a month on the rent.
Okay, but why is that move I just did? Let's pretend. Let's imagine. Suppose for a minute I was really crazy because Claudia is giving me shots of tequila all day long, and I could still do that deal. What would you say to me next? What did I just get, regardless of what I can do or not do? What did I get from that prospect?
A commitment to do mm-hmm. now.
Yes, exactly. I got a yes.
You got a yes right now. Yeah.
The psychology of the seduction, of persuasion. How important is it to get the prospect up the yes ladder? How important is it? It's huge. Right? Where's their mindset if they start saying yes, 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 I could do that. Yes, I could. What's their mindset? Is it more likely that you're in a position to renegotiate or fix the problem? Yeah.
Sure.
Absolutely. So, and did you hear the wishy-washy? You know, I always tell you guys to listen for the wishy-washy words. Which wishy-washy word did I just use before? Maybe, probably. Let's pretend. Let's imagine for a moment. Is that a commitment for me or a hypothetical?
Hypothetical.
Right. And now, so now you get the yes. Now you fix it with maybe what we talked about earlier, maybe a little struggling. Here's the okay. Here's the problem, Justin, or you go to me, Claude. Let's have a little fix the problem, Justin, real quick.
Okay, you want me to be the prospect or the salesman?
You were the salesman, okay. I believe, right?
All right. Here's the problem, Claude.
Yeah, I really need to do this deal, man. You're my last resort. Well,
okay. Imagine I were able to solve this problem for you and put somebody in the house that will take care of the house, love the house, ultimately buy the house.
I need some cash today, though, man.
And we're talking about in the short term here. Okay, yeah. Claude. The problem I have is that it's $150 a month too expensive on the rent. If we were to do this, I would need you to come down $150 on the rent. Is that something worth talking about, or is this conversation over?
My worthless son-in-law is in jail. This is the reason I need some cash today. I'll drop it down to one. I'll drop $150 if I can get a couple thousand today to bail the bum out.
Okay, so if I send you a written offer today reflecting what we just discussed, what happens next?
I'll do it, man. I'll sign anything. What's my
EQ? Sorry.
Let's do it, man. Let's do it.
Okay.
What's my EQ score? What's my emotional quotient right now? How did I come to him? As a 3, a 5, or a 10?
9.
I could have hit you more with that emotional stuff. I could have capitalized a little bit on, what did you say, your son-in-law? Well, yeah. if I were to send you an agreement that solves this problem and allows you to handle the son-in-law issue, what happens next, Claude?
Well, I just need that cash to bail him out. If I can get that some cash today, I'll sign anything, man. What's the danger? Has anyone here ever had a 10 right away, right on the a 10? We don't get enough of them, do we?
Yeah.
What's the danger of a 9 or a 10 prospect? What's the danger?
You could talk them into being a 3 real fast.
Yes. How many have met the salesman? You came in as for a 9 or 10. You wanted to buy the car, the TV, whatever. You wanted to just remove the pain really fast. Okay. How many times did the salesman, old school, not a gut salesperson, but a traditional salesman, how often do they go, oh, but I got to tell you all about the presentation and the features and benefits and the price goes up in front. How many of them, when they have a prospect who's a 10 and they go into the presentation, and where's the only other direction that prospect can go if they're at a 10? Can we close? Yeah. When we get somebody at a 10, what should we do? What should we do in the first 180 seconds?
Close
them.
Yes.
You can struggle a little, but go for the close. Some take yes for an answer. And then after you get the close, you worked out the finance, you qualified them, you get the contract or the commitment to the contract. Then you could maybe go into the features and benefits or whatever. When you get somebody who's a 5 or a 6, what do you have to do to develop them to get them up to an 8? People make decisions emotionally, don't they?
Correct.
Yeah. We got to keep them in that emotional state. What can we do? But gee, I don't know. Justin, I don't understand. Your son-in-law and he's in jail and you got to bail him out and everything. You know, I'm sure they'll let him out on his own recognizance in a week or two, you know.
I just really need, but I've made a commitment to him that I'll help him get out of jail. So
this is a really ugly role play.
Need to move forward with this. Because I've been needing to do this for a while anyway, Claude. So I'm ready to go. If your offer's still good.
Yeah, let's do it, man. Send me whatever you need. As long as I get that $5,000 so I can go to the bail bond guy, you got a deal, man. I'm ready. I'll do whatever you want. I trust you.
Okay. Well, we have a problem, Claude. I'm not going to be able to send you $5,000 today because I'm going to have to do a little work here first because you just called me today asking me to solve your problem, and I'm going to have to source the individual to move in there. And when we do that, we can provide the $5,000. I mean, is that a deal breaker for you?
Can you give me anything today, man? I'll you know. I can lower the price too. I mean.
Okay, well, if you lower the price by $10,000 and the rent by $150, and I send you $2,500 today, does that what does that do for us? Do we have a deal?
Wow. Yeah. I mean, you got me between a rock and a hard place, man.
Good.
Wouldn't we love to have prospects like this? Wouldn't we have loved it? Anybody have a quick question? I love just role playing with you guys, discussing qualification, closing. I don't know anything that helps you get on the phone to marketing. We had some good talks about attraction marketing today. If I can get you guys to get on the phone with 2, 3, up to 5 people a day and just have a follow up, ask their opinion, give the anything. Ty Sherwood, you must have sold that piece of land by now, right, buddy?
No, I still have it. Fortunately, it's
You and I spoke way back in December 2022. That's why I was calling here. I got a message from Siri, said to give you a call on my calendar here. You wouldn't want to sell it today, would you?
Yeah, I mean, I'm paying on that, and I'm paying on another 5 pieces as well. Oh. So that would really help me out. I don't know. Yeah. Could you help me out with that?
I think I can. Can I ask you to? You know what? Can I ask you 2, 3 quick questions? You ask me a few. I'll make you an offer, and let's see if we're a good fit and we can do business today and get all these bills out of your life and everything. If we can have a meeting of the minds, and if it's great, if it works great, we'll do something right now today. If not, I want you to tell me get lost. Can you fire me today if it's not right for you?
Sure. Yeah, that sounds like
you're a good winner. Oh, I'm so glad I made this call. You're a gentleman. You're old school. I love doing business with guys like you. Boom. How fast did it take me to get in that killer, in that beautiful? Am I in a beautiful little place? Thank you, Ty. Am I in a beautiful little place with Ty? How long did it take me? 30 seconds? Okay. That's why when you have a follow-up and you have information, do you have the right to follow up? If you give them a gift or an incentive or send them something, or you ask their opinion, do you have the right to, can you follow up? Today, is it harder today to get contact information than it's ever been before? I think so. What do you guys think? How reluctant are we to give away our phone numbers, our email, our mail address, God forbid our social security? How reluctant are we to give that information to people online today? It's a big problem.
Very.
It's really.
I hate giving it up.
Go ahead, Randy.
I hate giving any info out because you know you're going to get deluged with bullshit and all kind of email and everything. I hate it.
Yeah. So how do we... Go ahead.
Uncle Claude, I on my website have an opt-in form where people can put their email address and submit for like a free consultation or free book or something. And there's a box on it that says mobile phone number, and it's optional. And I just did that as a test to see what would happen because I felt the same way. But I can tell you that at least 50% of the people put their phone number in there of their own free will.
There you go.
Oh, yeah.
Instead of saying your phone number, say, why don't you text me your number so I can send you the link from Dropbox, so I can send you the information, the PDF, the book, this, anything. And then you follow up with that person. And then you use the gut system. You set the agenda. You do a little pattern interrupt in the beginning. Say, hey, did you get the information? Did you like it? Why are you interested in this? What's your opinion on the materials or on this or that? And hey, you know what? I think maybe there's a way I can help. Can I ask you a couple quick questions? Set your agenda. Second step, qualification. What is their score? What is their motivation? Okay. What is their time frame to solve this need or greed? what is their money situation? Okay, money's always a big qualifier, right? Whether you're buying or selling, you need to know the money, the terms. What's the mortgage payment? What's the value of the home? Whatever you have. Are they the decision maker? Are they the person who can make a decision today? Or how many times have we given this brilliant presentation to somebody and then they say, you know what, I got to talk to my significant other, my board of directors, my lawyer, or something like that. Do you want to find that out in the beginning or do you want to find that out at the end?
We'll always find it out right up front, yeah.
Right. And why? And then we always want to discuss character. We want to judge their character. Decide, okay, that's where your stroking, your nurturing, and your empathy come in, are so necessary. So, sir, imagine for a moment, or sir, let's pretend we could solve this or do this deal from 2 years ago. You wouldn't consider a negative redirection. You wouldn't consider negotiating with me right now, would you? Okay, you got to get a feel for their. Are they in a position? Are they motivated enough for you to negotiate? Can you close people on $1 million property in one phone call? You better believe it.
Sure.
People buy things emotionally. It's the most important thing I teach. They buy things emotionally. They make the judgment, the final. They ascertain it. Okay. Intellectually at the end. They justify it. That's the word I was looking for. They make the decision emotionally and they justify the decision. This is why I made this money, honey. This is why I spent all this money with Justin Chamness. He's a great guy. He's going to help me. He's going to help us sell this property. He's a good guy. He called me up today and everything like that. And he's got 20 years of experience. He's done deals like this. Boom. They go from the emotional to the intellectual. Okay. And so, and then you do, like I always say, the cigarette close. We're out of time, guys. It's a busy Monday. A lot of good stuff. Were you taking notes today? Nitzan, this was your first one. How'd you like it? Balloons? Do we get to party and confetti here?
Absolutely.
Fireworks? Maybe a little bit. Here's the new one, guys. This is the new one I just discovered. Laser Claude here. Okay, everybody, give yourselves a round of applause. Good session, good participation. Thank you. Go out there, talk to people, give good phone, and you'll see. I guarantee, I'll give you guys a guarantee. If everybody in this room today talks to a few people, potential prospects, follow-ups, I don't even care if you're going to Zillow or what, or you're going to a Howard Johnson's bathroom wall and copy the phone. No, don't do that. Okay. But go out there and talk to a few people today, make some offers, use the system, three little steps, learn, it's question-based, and you will see magic happen. You will make money this week. Have a good week, everybody. Thank you. Let me find some music here.
Thank you, Uncle Claude. It was awesome.
We always go out with music. Let's go. Oh, I love this song. It's a 5 o'clock world.
Sounds of the city pounding in my brain while another day goes down the drain.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But it's a 5 o'clock world.
New Carol, remember?
No one owns a piece of my
time. It was a great show.